Happy Halloween. Grab your camera gear, a pumpkin carving kit, and some smoke grenades. It's time for a spooky photo shoot. If you're looking to create some mysterious, Halloween-y, and let's not forget, awesome portraits this Samhain festival, you've probably thought about grabbing some smoke grenades. But it's not as easy as you might think, and I've assembled some tips to keep in mind when planning your shoot. Number one, safety first. These are not toys, and you can burn yourself if you're not careful. Always prioritize safety when lighting and holding smoke grenades. Number two, plan out your movements beforehand. These grenades burn fast, so always rehearse with your model multiple times before using any live smoke bombs. Number three, pick a day with little to no wind. Be sure to track the wind and make sure it isn't blowing towards the camera, ruining the shot. Now, where do you purchase these smoke grenades? I go through this website whenever I purchase them for my photography needs. For our Halloween-themed portrait, they have plenty of great colors that will fit our needs. I'll provide a link in the description as well. Start to think about props you would like to use in your photo shoot. We're going with a spooky, witchcraft in the woods sort of vibe, so my model, Emily, came with clothes that fit the tone, including a pointy hat. I also think it's cool when you place a smoke grenade inside the pumpkin and have the colorful smoke billow out. And being one of his favorite fall activities, Taurean was nice enough to bust out his kit and carve up some pumpkins. It was time to turn on the shining, make some hot cocoa, and bring our jack-o'-lanterns to life. For my lighting in this portrait, I kept it as simple as possible. I always kept the sun at the back of Emily, providing us with natural rim light. I didn't want to drag a whole bunch of lights into the woods, so I used the sun whenever I could. Then I used a 48-inch octabox for my key light. That's it. Keep it simple. Focus on the staging of your props and the movement of your model. That can make or break a photo shoot like this. I'm lucky enough to have a huge wooded area behind my house. We headed out there with all of our gear and started rehearsing our movements. I began with a bunch of portraits without any props or smoke grenades. This helped me dial in my lighting settings and get Emily comfortable with poses she wanted to hit. After that, it was time for the smoke grenades. When ready, have a helping hand, pull a pin, and hand the grenade to your model. Then shoot like crazy. I was on the Canon 5D Mark IV in high-speed continuous shooting mode, capturing 7 frames per second. Something important to keep in mind. If it doesn't go perfectly, please don't beat yourself up. Even with all of your prep work, smoke like this is unpredictable. The wind could change, blocking your model entirely with smoke. This has happened to me, and I even have proof. Plan on changing the color of your leaves from green to orange and yellow in Photoshop afterwards. Just use the hue saturation adjustment in Photoshop to isolate your greens and then play with your color adjustments. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on using smoke grenades in your next photo shoot. Remember, keep it spooky and keep it safe. Thanks for watching this video. As always, please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to keep videos like this coming your way.